their chairs, like, not buckled in tight enough. Oh, it's making noise. Okay, I think that's official enough for you guys. I have the vest, the shirt, the pants, and I do have the coat. So yeah, that's what I wore today. It was a pretty interesting day. It was one of those strange days, I think, for all of us. It was really strange. Because the first, I started at 6, okay? And that means I had to wake up at like 4:30. So I was up at 4:30 and I went to bed at like 12-ish or so. Anyways. And went to bed, woke up 4:30, left the house by 5:30. And we got to the station around, it's close to 6. Then we did our rig check off, and then we had our first call. I don't remember what it was, because, okay, so when you're on an A-plus, you can't remember the person's name. You can't remember, like, their social security number. You can't remember their insurance. You can't remember everything. Just, you know, by a brief report of what happened, I don't remember it. So, and that was around, like, 7 when we got our first call. Then we didn't get back to, like, you know, from that call, we have to, like, take him to the hospital. Then from there, we need to do a run report. Then we're clear. I think that one took, like, an hour and a half or so-ish. Anyways. So that part went by, like, really fast. Like, the first 3 hours went by really fast. And then from, like, 9 to 12, it kind of seemed like normal time. Like, it felt like it was going the way it should be. And then from 12 to, like, 4, or, yeah, 12 to 3, it was, like, slowing down a little bit. And then from, like, 3 to 6, it was like, oh my gosh, I'm so home. Like, towards the end, okay, so on one of the calls, this is not going to make any sense to you guys if you kind of, like, don't understand, but I'll try to dumb it down. When we, as an ambulance company, we get a call. And basically what we're going to be, we got that call as a backup. So, like, the fire department gets called first. And if they need us, we go in right after them. So we need to be there in case, you know, they need us right away. If not, we just sit there and we wait till they say, okay, well, we don't need you, then we just leave. But we're at least 50 feet away from the truck or the, what are they called? Fire engine, there we go. So we, on one of the calls, she just forgot about us. She left us there and, like, no one called us or anything. Okay, yes, I get the point. Yes, Skyping. I think we were kind of there for, like, I think probably an hour. She kind of, like, forgot about us. So we just all kind of, like, fell asleep a little bit. Like, Steve was kind of, like, my mom's boyfriend is kind of, like, you know, half awake, just in case, because, like, as soon as that beeper goes, you need to be, obviously, going. So he was kind of half awake, and then my mom was gone for a little bit, then, like, half awake, and then I was just, like, in the back. I wasn't even that tired, honestly. And for the rest of the day, the calls were just kind of, I mean, I guess some of them were interesting a little bit, but nothing I really wanted. Like, this is going to sound really, really bad, but I really want to see a full-blown seizure, because I've seen one, but that wasn't that great of a seizure. I want to see one, like, really bad seizure. I want to see a really bad motor vehicle accident. I want to see a shooting, a stabbing, and one other one. Oh, something blocked in the airway. So I know it sounds really bad, but it really interests me. It really does. It really interests me. Oh, and on one of our calls, we did get to go to a motor vehicle accident, but it wasn't Okay, so what happened was one of our other rigs, not my rig, not the one we were on, but the same company that we were on, another number of ambulance, they were called to that scene of the motor vehicle accident, and they took one guy who was seriously injured, like, was really badly injured, and went to the hospital. Then asked, you know, hey, do you want us to call the other crew in for the other guy that was in the car? Because obviously two people need to be in a car accident. And apparently he refused it, so, and about 45 minutes later, they call us in, and they go, well, now the other guy's having, you know, leg troubles and everything, so we're like, okay. So it wasn't bad, you know, he was in the motor vehicle accident, but he just had, like, back troubles and everything, so whatever. Other than that, I had an 11-month, I think, yeah, an 11-month-year-old. She had burns up and down her arms and her legs, because apparently it was hot water, but I don't think it was hot water. I think it was some other, I don't know, it was some type of liquid, but it wasn't hot water. So that was all up and down her leg and everything, and she's crying, obviously, because it's in pain. And yeah, I felt that. Anyways, we transported her. We had another 2-year-old with neck pain who was, it's kind of bullshit call, but well. I had the motor vehicle accident dude. I had, okay, what? Really? I'm not going to answer you right now. I'm vlogging here. I had a lady. We had transporting a couple of, we have like 3 private calls. You're not going to understand that, so don't worry about that. And we had one, I think this was our first one too. So the lady, what was wrong with her? Oh, she had knee pain, and that was another bullshit call. Really bullshit call. I think that was it. It's kind of a slow day. So I hope to go back in a couple of months, or like a month or so, and do it again. And I'm really looking forward to it, because I really like this. For some reason, I really, really, really like this.